wouldn't it?
God, Captain.
Trouble? Yes. He's been hounding me. These Templars strut around as it is, but now it's just out of hand.
If you're going to coddle your men, expect someone to take issue.
What in blazes are you talking about?
Cullen has heard complaints about you as captain.
Complaints? From who?
Who cares? I need to know if you're going soft.
I don't like what you're implying.
It's a simple question.
Then let me give them, and you, an answer. If they think I'm coddling anyone, it'll be my husband, Donick. You and I will intercept his patrol tonight. Then you can see for yourself if I'm coddling him, or any in my command.
Well, I could do with a breath of fresh air.
You'll be lucky if you have time. You'll see. No one questions me or my men. Donick's patrol, Hawk. Me and you, tonight. Accuse me of being soft. Not in this lifetime.
Set.
Thank you for coming, Champion. Few will associate with me now that I am the focus of Meredith's ire, which leaves me in a difficult position. She is not entirely wrong. I know some of my people are using dangerous means to oppose her, but I cannot seek the Templars' aid without making every mage a target.
What are they doing?
All I know is numerous mages have left the Circle at night, sometimes for days at a time. I'd rather not follow our Knight Commander by leaping to the worst possible conclusion. But the idea of blood magic has crossed my mind.
You need some assistance against traitors in your ranks.
Traitors? Perhaps. Rebels? Certainly. I don't know if they seek congress with demons or merely a walk in the moonlight.
Walking's not so bad. Even mages need exercise.
All I know is that a meeting is happening tonight in Hightown. I would go myself, but should I leave the tower without permission, Meredith would call it proof of my involvement.
So I shouldn't slit my wrists and dance naked under the moonlight just to fit in?
If that's what you intend, perhaps I'll join you after all. Just learn the nature of this meeting. You needn't interrupt unless you find proof of something sinister. I pray not. Or Meredith will have what she needs to justify the right of annulment.
The Templars are more isolated than ever. I'm often shut out, even as guard captain.
Champion, I hope my letter found you well. Hopefully you...
Donic will be on this route.
Let's see how hard you sweat your men.
Or is it always champion now? You're too much of a chameleon, my friend.
Never mind, Donick. I need to know if Aveline is giving you easy patrols.
Did I make this seem that easy? I assure you, my wife gives me no special treatment.
What a crime.
Yes, Isabella. That is something you would say. Tell me what's going on.
It's all right. Go ahead.
Every guard chooses the patrol they want. My wife promotes from the bold, not the reckless. Action is up, casualties are down. It is remarkable. As are you, love.
Thank you. That will do.
Another time, Sir Arhawk. Safe travels.
That should be sufficient. Take that to the Templar.
Indeed. Let's go talk to Cullen.
Champion, and you are with the captain. None too happy about the accusations against her, I'm sure.
You could say that.
The claims against Aveline are garbage. Did you bother to verify them?
No.
Then why press this?
Some feel that the solution to the current crisis of leadership is to consolidate authority. As long as these complaints continue, baseless or not, they will serve as justification for eliminating the position of guard captain. It would be the simplest fix, whether or not I agree.
They want to lie about her. Let them do it to her face.
I have no objection, but the Anonymous are rarely so brave. I can say that all of the complaints have originated in Lowtown.
Guardsman Brennan is on that patrol. Why wouldn't she tell me of this?
I don't know, but I do apologize for the assumptions of this incident, Guard Captain. It has been unfortunate.
It's not done. To Lowtown, Hawk. I need to speak to Brennan. You know, Isabella, if someone had told me that I'd put up with you for all these years, I'd have punched them flat.
And if someone had told me I'd still be here, I'd have done the same.
You have your ship. What's stopping you?
And what would you do without me as a constant headache in the road?
Someone would rush to fill the hole. You know, like you never left.
That's my girl.
Maybe you win once in a while. out of breath.
For the next. And you die! Nothing like the smell of fresh blood.
No.